Well, first, I want to thank all the parents and families here today and our faculty and staff. We literally couldn't be here without you, so thank you so much. And to the class of 2017, we made it. All right. In about an hour or so, we're going to stand around the flagpole, hopefully. Come on, Darby. And sing the alma mater one last time together. Well, maybe at our 5-year reunion, after a few of us have had a few too many, that melody that has been so insistently drilled in our brains might just reappear, say, on the patio at 2 in the morning when they can't quite kick us out. But for all intents and purposes, this is it, our last song. Now, originally I had a joke here about how all non-choir members don't really know the words to our alma mater, and you just all sing along whenever Ms. Karam walks by you and pokes you and makes you sing it. But just as Mr. Berner so eloquently noted yesterday, you all showed me outside Pierce House Monday night that you definitely do know the words. So good job. Yeah. But for those of you visiting with us today, you can find our alma mater on the inside of your program. I remember the first time I heard and attempted to sight read Old Reserve. I was in the far corner of the balcony, our first Monday morning meeting, standing next to Dresden. Before any formal introduction, not even a hi, I'm Danny, Dresden points to the person's name on the top right corner of the yellow laminated sheet music, Ralph E. Fluwell, and said, "That's my great-great-uncle." And standing on my left was none other than the grandson of the John DeYoung. Elliot and Dresden, you are both amazing independent people. But that was one intimidating way to start my first day of school. Ever since my profound first encounter with the alma mater, I've been fascinated by it. Now, I'm a little skewed because I'm crazy enough to want to spend the next 4 years of my life studying choral music education. But every time we sang, every time we sang it, I couldn't help but wonder, why? Why these words? What inspired Dresden's great-great-uncle to write this? And why the heck do we sing this nearly every Monday? I spent all these Monday morning meetings thinking through these questions, trying to find the motivation and story behind our alma mater. Sorry, Mr. Warner. I try my best to find the symbols and deeper meaning, but Dresden's great-great-uncle is no Coleridge, and I couldn't find the albatross. But one day, a few weeks ago, as I was running the cross-country course, a wave of nostalgia hit me and something clicked. In that moment, I was an onlooker to 4 years worth of amazing memories running across lawns wide sweep. I can nearly see Enon Cole running with me, Baxter Botensky Bartlett chasing whatever he so desired with unlimited energy, and Senor Frazier standing at the top of the hill yelling, "Go!" This is when I found the story behind Old Reserve. Now imagine our songwriter revisiting Reserve after, say, 20 years. The first thing he sees is lots of green, thank you Vismeg Landscaping, and lots of brick buildings. He sees fair halls amid a lawn's wide sweep. But of course our songwriter sees more than that. This place holds his memories just as it holds ours. Ellsworth Hall holds countless conversations with our amazing dining hall staff. Seriously, thank you guys. Who gave me immeasurable patience and kindness every day, serving me a gluten-free, dairy-free, garlic-free, oat-free meal. Thank you. I'm sorry. On to Seymour, continuing the joyful pursuit of wisdom in the Latin room with Mr. Namioka and Mr. Manoli's legendary playlist. I hope I'm not the only one who will never forget that heart-dropping feeling the first time Mr. Ong assigned an A-push reading, and our sophomore year English class with Jebs, which will forever ask the all-important question, who watches the watchman? There, I found my desire to teach, and just a short walk down to Hayden Hall with our lovely Miss Karam, she helped me realize, why not teach music? So, I mean, we'll always remember the joy of making music in Hayden and hearing Sydney's beautiful, heart-stopping voice. Now our songwriter can look up anywhere on campus and find a tower rising over the trees. This chapel holds our podium, our voices, and some of our bravest and brightest moments. The courage of McKenna Sr.'s speech will never leave the chapel, nor will the beautiful, real truth of Madison's poetry. I know I'll always remember Mrs. Minoli's "my lot" every time I entered her office, and I'm pretty sure none of us will ever forget Andrew Wu absolutely shredding Millionaire's Hoedown on the violin. After our songwriter takes a deep breath from all this nostalgia and memories that the buildings hold, he snaps back to reality and realizes, geez, it's hot in this suit and tie, and my legs are really tired. Hence our next stanza. Long walks green aisles, whose shadows deep scarce flicker in the summer breeze. Hey, at least we don't have to walk to the pods next year. But hey, these long walks in the scorching heat, or even during our March 3rd blizzard this year, make the air conditioning and fireplace of the library that all that much more inviting. Inside, you will always remember the lucky moments full of wisdom and smiles with Mrs. Donnelly and Miss Spencer and all our other amazing librarians. Our songwriter can't help but note the chapel bell's recurring song, which brings back memories of our Mr. Metcalf speaking at our annual Veterans Day service and always being there for us in the MAC. The noisy ball field's eager throng. Translation, Mr. Hoffman's iconic baseball playlist blaring from the home dugout in Pioneer Park. But these aren't the only sounds that will always fill the lawn's wide sweep. Reserve will never forget the voice of our class. Shout out to Nick Harris and our email class chain. Nice work. Now, I was only able to name a few of my memories here, and I'm only one of about 114 of us, one of exactly 114 of us. Now, Mr. DiBiase can back me up. The multiplications and combinations equal out to be about a boatload of memories, relationships, and friendships. So when we sing, O long may time these things preserve around thy walls, dear old reserve, for one last time, I hope that your memories of friendship, hard work, and being a part of something greater than yourself never fade away. I truly hope that long after we sing this last song, as long as we can remember this place, we can remember the people, relationships, and friendships we formed here. My classmates, look around at our audience here today. Our teachers, coaches, parents, advisors, maintenance guys, dining hall staff, librarians have all worked so hard these past 4 years to pull us all closer to wisdom and show us how to live content, meaningful lives. I hope we can do this for others as well. And finally, look around at our amazing class. They've given us friendships for life. That's priceless. And to everyone else here today, watch out for the untamable class of 2017. We are dreamers and doers, and we will never give up. Because this isn't our last song. We just started making music. Thank you for these unforgettable 4 years.